Hey everybody, thanks for stumbling upon this video. I've never done anything like this before, so this will be new. Today I'm going to show y'all the recreation of the beast at King's Island that I've built in Minecraft. This will just kind of be like it'll be kind of in-depth, show you everything that I've done so far. So first of all, here's like an overview from a high angle. So you can see we have station, containment one, containment two, main station. We even have the slaughterhouse building, the haunt queue area. If I go further, there is the train shed, and then here is the first lift hill. This all works too. It surprisingly works. Back in here, you can see the helix, which was surprisingly hard to do in Minecraft because it's, you know, a circle, but it's still that. There's the second lift hill. You can see the intricate design of the track there. Out here, you can see that little airtime, big air quotes there, hill. You can see that little canopy area you run through, and then this is where it all goes into the tunnels underground. And then it loops back around, goes to the second lift hill, and then back out to the helix. Now, you're probably wondering, hey, this is a super flat world. How the heck did you get to go underground and stuff? Well, it's easy. It's easy in practice, but what we did was, well, we as in me, I built a bunch of artificial hills, which I'll come down here and show you, to make enough room to where I could build on top of the surface, but still seem like it's going underground. So if I come up here, you can see that when you go down in here, this is actually bedrock level here. And then you come back out and all the fake little hills. So I did that. I also put one here. This one was kind of more for looks. That's not real life accurate. There's not really a hill there. And then there is some more. There's another one back here. A lot of it got covered up by the trees. Oops. A lot of it got covered up by the trees, but that's okay. I put one for this little canopy area as well. Made this little artificial lake. The really interesting one was out here where you go into the tunnel, because that was a big thing. It's like, how am I going to make it to where you're going to go into the tunnel when it's a super flat world? And you can go like three layers down before you hit the bottom of the world. So I literally built this huge artificial hill. You can kind of see it there. It took a lot of time because you have to map out kind of where you're going. You have to really think like, okay, how does this layout go? And what do I need to do to get it there? So you can kind of see from the top, if you really use your imagination, where the cursor is, it goes in through there. You can see the tall tree lines. It goes right about where that black is there. Come back around and then comes back out to the surface. I'm also putting some little ponds as well. I will say as well that I did work at King's Island for a few years, so all of these little roads and stuff that you see, like this little gravel road, and out here there's a little shed. This is all accurate, one for one, if you want to call it that. But it's relatively close. It's close enough to where, you know, it's believable for, even for myself. So let's go ahead. I'll take you to the station. We'll do a quick ride, and then I can go over some of the special features I've built as well. Right down to the station, I try to get it as accurate as possible. So if we take a look here, here is the station. There's that big gate they have. See Beast Canyon cold drinks. You can go in here. That's a switch I'll show you in a minute. Beast Canyon. And if you go this way, here we are in containment area one. And just like in real life, if you really know the beast, you know there's this little area that goes down and you can sit on the underneath the handrails, and this is that exact area. Maybe kind of monotonous to go through all the queues, but helps you get the full experience. And there's so much redstone and stuff underneath it here. It's pretty crazy. Right down to the lamp on the right side and not the left. Then you do that little tight turn if you know. Here we are in containment area 2. Looks like it's getting dark. Let's go ahead and make it daytime again. Time, day. Cool. Let's see, there's a little door. Go around. All right, here's where the ramp starts to come in. Here you've got the ramp. And I put a lot of effort in trying to make it as accurate as possible. Like this view here, I literally pulled up a picture from my phone of what this view looks like, and I tried to make it as accurate as possible, right down to the angle on that roof, the blue sticking out from behind of the facade, the emergency exit door sticking out there. There's this curve here, and we're heading up. You can see down here the fast lane line and the handicap entrance. I did not recreate the old waterfall piece yet. More or less, I just don't have enough room considering the blocks you have in Minecraft. It makes it a little difficult. Here we are where you go front or back, which kind of they don't do anymore, but I still have it here because that's the way we like to do it. I have redstone lamps up here to with the daylight sensors on them, so they come on at night. So here is the ride area. So let's go ahead and take a ride. Let me get a mine cart. Let's see. All right. Let's hop in. Let's take a ride on the Minecraft beast. We'll be right back. And that is the Beast. So, you may have noticed a few things while going around, like Slaughterhouse sitting there, some of the trim breaks I added for realism. But let me show you some of the cool things about the station, first of all. You may have noticed that there is exactly 18 rows of gates here, just like on the real Beast. This lever here, see how the gates are open there? Let's fix that. Let's see if we can get to where you can see the view. There they all go. Now they're all closed. Let's watch again. Turn it on. There they go. So that was a lot of fun. Redstone can be mind-boggling to say the least, but it was fun to do. Another thing I'll show you is the fact, well, I'll show you the exit ramp. This is about as accurate as I could get it. Ramps are hard to do in Minecraft because it's, you know, blocks, but you gotta do it the best with what you got sometimes. Got the American flag. If I go down here, I'll show you the, so this would be normally the way you exit. Once again, try to make it as accurate as possible. About the only thing that's missing is the tall fence, but I liked the view, so I didn't really want to put a tall fence there. That lever that's over here in the greeter entrance, the greeter spot where the entrance is. See, there's a sign here. It says empty for up, down for full. So right now I have it at full, which means all the line is full. So all of the queue dividers are closed. So you have to go around the queue like I did. If I switch it to empty, they will all open up. So you can see they are open now. If we take a look at that gate right there, if I go back and flip the switch, it will close. So, and then that counts for these as well. These will open and close along with it. So I can actually show you some of the redstone work here. In the old snack bar area, which they kind of just use for storage now, I put the redstone. So you can just see it's just a big hollow building. But in here, you'll see gate electrical room. And you can see where the redstone goes. And the way I did this, actually, I built a giant cube underneath bedrock. So if I actually break the wall here and fly out, you can see I'm in the void. And there's this gigantic cube underground to house all of the electrical stuff, because you have to hide it somehow. And this was about as good as I could do, considering it's on a super flat world. But I'd rather have it on a super flat world than a world where I have to get rid of trees and stuff. So containment one is this way, containment two is that way. You can just follow the trail. And then if I head up here, you can see all of the redstone torches that, I guess we could just say ignite the gates. If I head over here, you can see the same thing for containment one. If I head back out, I will show you, I'll fix that hole later. Show you the electrical that is underneath the station, which is actually kind of accurate because they keep stuff like that underneath the station at King's Island. But let us, I'll go up the exit. We'll take the fast lane ramp. You can get that vibe if y'all are ever lucky enough to use the fast lane. You can see fast lane plus and the handicap symbol. Plus actually got taken away this year, so now they're a little bit cheaper, which is nice. But let's head up here, the fast lane ramp. As you can see, you come, that's where you would go for handicap and fast lane plus. So if I head down in here, this is the electrical area. This is underneath the station. So you can see here are the, which will be on the other side. Here are the redstone torches for the gates. So if I were to go up there and flip that switch, those red bulbs would go out and it would close the gates. And if I head down here into this big cube here, you can see some more of the power that goes for it. But a lot of this is things that I have yet to show you. So the Beast in real life has tunnel lighting. for maintenance. Sometimes they turn them on just for the hell of it, but here we have, you can see I had a little fun with signs here. High voltage, love my signs. Tunnel 1 lighting, if lit, lights are on. Tunnel 2 lighting, if lit, lights are on. So if I flip these switches, you'll notice that the lights in Tunnel 1, which is the bottom of the first lift hill, so the first main drop, and then Tunnel 2, which is kind of towards the middle of the ride where you go, make like a little S, it will light the lighting in there. So let me go ahead and make it dark outside before I do so. Oops, let's see. Exit. Time, and we'll do midnight. Okay, so I'm gonna flip this. Redstone torch comes on. I'm gonna flip that. Redstone torch comes on. So let's head out and let's take a look at the tunnels. You can see the lighting. The lighting looks really cool because it goes through the structure. I also have the lamps at the top to recreate that big spotlight they have so they can see on the camera. It's just a couple daylight sensors, a couple redstone lamps. But if I head down here, you will see the light's on in here. It's just a red redstone torch, nothing too big. But since that tunnel is so short, it's hard to really get the full experience. So let's head out to Tunnel 2, which is here. Kind of missed, but we can fly over. Let's see here. And you can see now there are lights on. I have them all numbered, kind of hidden. 1, 2, and this one will say 3. But I have it numbered so that way if some of the wiring gets messed up, however, it's kind of hard to do that in something like that in creative, but if it does get messed up, I'll be able to trace it and find it easily. What does this one say? Oh, 7. Yeah, 7's over there. So let me show you how all of that works. The only thing about redstone, I had to do a lot of redstone repeaters, and I had to build gigantic 1x2 tunnels from the station all the way out to the tunnels. So let's go out here. And then while it's dark, I'll show you the real pretty station lighting. Especially during haunt, sometimes during rest season, they have red light bulbs. So I put some red stained glass over it. I put brown to kind of dim the lighting. Looks a lot better in real life, but you know, what else, what doesn't? So let us head out here and I'll show you where all of the wiring goes. If I can double click, there we go. So if we head in here, you can actually follow the trail. So you can see the wires are dim now because they're actually lit. So this goes to Tunnel 2. So if I go all the way out here, you can take a look at my position. You can see the numbers going up. This took a long time. Once again, you can see why I had to build artificial hills because, you know, I'm only a few feet under the ground and I'm already at bedrock. Once you have bedrock, you'd have to build giant cubes like I did for the queue lighting. And as you can see, we are now where the tunnel is. So we are underneath my fake little tunnel. You can see it's pretty much just a facade made of dirt. And once again, there's the numbers. So there's number 1, so that way I don't have to break this every time. I can just know exactly where the torch is. Over here will be number 2, number 3, and so on. So it's all hidden under there. It works surprisingly well. But this was actually a lot of fun, as much as it was monotonous. But we can fly back for you guys. And I ran into a lot of trouble too, where I had roads built, and you could kind of see it in the tunnel, to where when I dug down, the road just collapsed because a lot of it was gravel to make it as realistic as possible, because a lot of the roads out there are gravel. But we did the best with what we got, and this one goes to Tunnel 1, but I won't. Actually, I will go out there because I'll show you something else that we have. You may have noticed on the ride we took, the camera lens flash. You kind of have to use your imagination, but I put a detector rail and created a flash for the camera to take your ride photo. So you can see here, once again, we're underneath one of our little facades of a tunnel. And this black I put inside of this little dirt area to try to help make it more dark. You can see hotshot camera lighting wires and tunnel one maintenance light wires. So the reason it says hotshot is because that is what the camera is called in real life. They use hotshot cameras with big flashes. I'll show you the wiring for that in a second, but once again, you can see the redstone trail goes up, and that's where that light is, right there in that first tunnel. You can actually see the track here. It's this piece of wood, and this is just the tunnel. Let me go ahead, and I'll show you guys the lighting wiring. So the way these detector rails work, when a minecart rolls over it, it works as a pressure plate, and it creates a current, and it shoots the redstone through there, and going up to this redstone lamp. I put the target there because the hotshot logo is a target, and that's about as close as I get to a camera, something like that. So I think it looked a lot better than the dispenser. So if I start this cart up here, you watch, the wires will turn brighter red, and the flash will go off on the camera. There it goes. I wanted to make it to where it would flash 5 times like it does in real life, but beggars can't be choosers, and that worked really well. So I was happy with that. Along with all of this, you may notice all of the back roads, which are all as accurate as you can make them. So here's the little maintenance road where they pull out to check where the trains are parked. I'll do this at flying so that way it doesn't get too boring. Let's see here. You can see caution low clearance. You go underneath the first lift hill support structure, just like in real life. We are passing the first drop. I'll go down that path in a little bit. And now we're underneath this monstrosity, which looks really cool from down here. There was a barbed wire fence, about as good as you can do in Minecraft, just like in real life. And it's funny because the train car is actually stuck there, because there's nobody in it. Put the stop sign, just like in real life. Let's go this way. So this way, I'll take you a few different areas. Here's a stop sign. You can go up this little gravel road. Once again, these are all accurate. Steep grade, use low gear. Here is the second lift hill motor house where they keep the gears that move the lift chain for the second lift hill. All vehicles must check in with guard. I had a little bit of fun with that. That's not completely accurate. As you can see, this is just hollow. I didn't put nothing in here. But there's a little guard shack I built. Security. Little dude. What's up, man? Out here, 4x4 vehicles only pass this point. No golf carts. There's a stop sign. So this path, honk horn twice before completing turns. That is accurate. This path, you can see some of the fake little hills that I've made. If I head out here, this will actually take us to the exit of the second tunnel. So I'll show you that. So right now we're actually going over it. That's what's underneath of us, is that track. Then we're going to go right back over it. Once again, these paths are about as accurate as you can get in Minecraft. And with the space and the way I built it allowed me to. You can see I had some fun with the fake little water here. And just like in real life, the path puts you out right here, near the exit of the second tunnel. And then I'll save us the time of walking. I'll fly over. If I come over here, back to where the guard shack is. This is where we turned to go in before. Low grade sign is. Here we go, there's a little sign, B station lake access. So there's a little lake out here. So I'll show you that. Another thing too, all of these trees were planted by hand and grown with bone meal. You can see it in my inventory, which, yes, as monotonous as it sounds, took a long time. I think I've spent more time on trees than I have in electrical lighting and building the beast structure itself. It's very very long, but it makes it look really, really nice. So that's all that matters. Hey, there's a donkey back here. What's up, man? So you can see the water. It's real nice. There's actually a little bit of a waterfall, kind of. Had a little bit of fun with that. And then if I head back out here and I go back to the middle, here we are here. If I go out this way, there is helix access. So I go down this path. This is how you get to the path in the middle of the helix. That way will take you towards Slaughterhouse and to the left of the first lift hill instead of the right. And here, this is just kind of a dead end because I don't really know what to do with this area. Bunch of pigs, though. What's up, pigs? Hello. But if I head back out this way. This path goes around the helix, which I'll get to in a little bit. Let's head back out towards the station, which will be this way, and I'll show you the path underneath of the first left hill, which is this one right here. So actually, I can see here we're going underneath the first lift. This is the brake run into the station, and then this is the first left hill. Placing all of these fence posts took a long time. For those of you that don't know Minecraft, each one of these little blocks that's highlighted here is that. You know, when you put two together, they complete a fence, but placing each one of those by hand was a lot of fun. And you can actually see, I just happened to hit exactly where one of my tunnels is. It's pretty funny. But if I head out here, this is the path underneath the first lift hill. That goes into the helix area. And actually, this is the path that goes around the helix. I'm not going to walk around it fully, but there's the helix tunnel. And there's the path that goes around it. This is a staircase that I made for access doors that go into the helix. In real life, this part is actually really close to the ground. But once again, since this is a super flat world, I didn't have the ability to do that. And the fact that everything is in blocks made that even more difficult. So I didn't do that. But this area isn't seen as much. But you can see that little black path goes around and it comes back out up here. But if I go, we came out through here, this road goes along, and it actually goes out to Slaughterhouse, just like in real life. If you ever notice, there's trucks when you're in line for the beast right about there, you'll see them drive through, and then they'll cut through the trees and go underneath the first lift hill. Let me see. We'll also show you the Slaughterhouse area. So if you know, in real life, this is a big gate that just opens up, but I put, you know, authorized personnel, requires lockout to get in. Back here is actually just a trash compactor, fun fact. This is that path that leads underneath the first lift hill. But say it's haunt season and Slaughterhouse is open. I recreated the lines. There's a lot of cows out here. Hello, guys. As you can see, there's the fright lane line, and here is the entrance. The entrance, just like in real life, goes out here, makes a big little loop, and it comes back around here. Oops, that's not the middle. I can go this way, and it'll lead us right to the Slaughterhouse. Once again, you kind of have to work with what you got with Minecraft. I can't spell out Slaughterhouse, so I just kind of try to recreate the shape of the logo. So let's go ahead and make it nighttime. Let's head in. Here is Slaughterhouse. So this is a lot of fun to make. I actually just finished this yesterday, time of filming. I used some of the pigling heads. You can see the little blades. I used some redstone blocks. I had a lot of fun with the new feature of the poses for the armor stands. So that was a lot of fun. A lot of this, you kind of have to use your imagination, but that makes it a lot more fun. Oh, there's a zombie here. Oh my gosh. There's another blade. Hey, there's a pig there. Interesting. A pig in Slaughterhouse. Who would have guessed? Created some running water. You can pretend that's blood. There's another pigling there. Skeleton. Eddie, soldier. And it's magma. I believe that's magma. I'm not exactly sure. All easy to get stuck in the cobwebs, though. We head this way. You'll actually see there's a pig trapped in here. It's the guy we've seen before. Hello, Mr. Pig. Here is another guy. He is worshiping the pickling head with all the cobwebs and the blade. We head this way. Check it out. Bunch of pigs and cows under there, about ready to be slaughtered. They follow through this whole path with the little gates. This isn't as accurate as the beast is, but it does work for what it's supposed to do. There's another pigling. This little area is cool because you have to walk in between them worshiping. If you go out here, it's just another little path with all the little faces on the wall. There's a zombie. It's more of that magma or whatever it's called on the floor. And here's our last little room. He's pointing at you to get on the blades to die. Let's get stuck in the cobweb, and then that's the last little guy. And out you go. So that's the slaughterhouse building. I also put the garage door on the back, just like in real life. I forget what that block is actually called, but it's definitely not supposed to be a garage door, but it works for your imagination. And then you got the exit, just like in real life. It takes you around the line to get in and puts you out there. So that's pretty much it as far as this ride. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Now, if I ever add anything significant, I'll be sure to let you guys know and post a little video about it. But that is my recreation of the Beast of Minecraft. Let me know your comments, anything you got, and thanks for watching.